The United Nations is said to be the Gambia government's most trusted partner in development. The United Nations sister agencies have been in support of the government's development plan in various sectors. Strengthening this cooperation, a three-day visioning exercise is ongoing at the Sardaudakarabajara Conference Center by officials from the UN system. Senior government officials and other stakeholders in development are gathered to dialogue and brainstorm on developing a sustainable development cooperation framework to support the government's green recovery-focused National Development Plan 2023-2027.
This workshop will identify and validate critical national priorities to help the Gambia achieve the 2030 Agenda for Sustainable Development.
This forum, according to the UN Resident Coordinator, Ms. Seraphine Wakana, is historic and important in supporting the elaboration of the UN cooperation framework in the Gambia by identifying and guiding the UN system for the next 5 years.
Over the next 3 days, we hope to benefit from your diverse expertise and experience. And according to our count of registered participants, 132 organizations representing various sectors, including the government, the UN, civil society, international organizations, the media, academia, and private sector have registered to help us in this momentous task.
In the past few years, countries around the globe have been challenged with setbacks such as the COVID pandemic, the Russia-Ukraine war, climate change, and a host of others, in which the Gambia is no exception. To better prepare themselves and diverse measures of sustainability, they gathered to develop a mechanism to sustain the current realities. The Minister of Finance and Economic Affairs, C.D. Keita, lauded the UN office in the Gambia for its continuous support to the government. The exercise, he said, will help accelerate sustainable development goals.
I encourage the United Nations system to further deepen this collaboration, to foster stronger alignment between the recovery-focused National Development Plan and the cooperation framework for enhanced ownership on the part of the stakeholders, which is crucial for effective implementation.
According to the Secretary General and Head of the Civil Service, the workshop is timely as it reconciles with the new development plan of the government. The
new RFNDP has fully integrated the concepts and needs for recovery while recognizing the need to address medium to long-term impacts of climate change. As expected, the cooperation framework, once finalized, will serve as a basis for UN support to the government towards realizing the Gambia's medium-term development aspirations as enshrined in the RFNDP.
The Gambia, according to the UNDAV evaluation findings, has seen improvements in some sectors, including governance, education, and life expectancy, registering slight increases. However, there is still room for improvement and the need to make the private sector the engine of growth of the Gambia's economy.
The government's assessment of the last NDP shows that the plan made some achievements, but progress was limited due to factors such as the COVID-19 pandemic, lack of effective institutional arrangements, and challenges in achieving the sustainable development goals due to the lack of data.
Participants were urged to take stock of all aspects of development, leaving no one behind, especially women and children, who are often marginalized, so as to develop an all-inclusive cooperation framework. Rohibite, GRTS.